Wolverine. Sunday's co-headliner was the Swedish band Wolverine. Their melancholic form of prog metal has been around for many, many years, and they actually performed at Progpower many, many years, holding the record of being the band that played there the most times. However, they're not just being booked because they are the house band. They're being booked on the fact that they just deliver very high quality shows. I got the chance to have an interview with the guys in Wolverine, and I went backstage with them and had a long chat about a multitude of subjects.
Hi everyone, here with the TDW vlog, and we're here with the guys from Wolverine.
Yay!
Oh, woo! Yeah!
Awesome!
Yeah!
Yeah! How are you guys doing?
Very good.
Yeah, you just had your performance, right? So, still high from the good vibes?
Yeah, it's
relaxed now, so to speak. Very, you know, after a show, you all get like this.
Yeah, exactly.
Up there, you have the energy. So to speak.
You had your adrenaline rush and that translates into then afterwards.
Exactly.
I think the problem for us is that we play so, it's so far apart. I mean, we haven't played like in 2.5 years with this kind of setting. We did like maybe 2 acoustic shows in between, but it's 2.5 years when we were on a stage like this playing.
Wow,
yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So you get this nervous tension before, so it's really nice.
Like the standard answer that people give is, but you've played before, right? But even if the time between it is so long, it's totally logical that you do get a certain sense of stress before you go on
it's
again.
It's like starting all over again.
Because I got 3 questions, which I always go for, like open questions, and you guys can be as extensive and, you know, in whatever way you want to, because I think those give the most original answers in general. So the first question I want to go for is, if you would meet like a total blank person who would have never heard of Wolverine before, how would you describe the music to that person?
I really don't know how I should explain it. Because, you know, everything is music in the end, right?
Yeah.
It's, you know, as at least I feel it when we create music, it's like we create music, and if it is something that we feels right and feels good, then it will become that.
Exactly.
So if we feel someday that we really love this Latino vibe, you know. maybe
there will be a scared face on the side here for a second. Like, what?
Maybe there will be a Latino song. You know, I think it's easier for someone that maybe have followed us some years.
Yeah, like an outsider in that
respect.
Yeah,
an outsider.
But that's why I'm asking you, because, obviously, I want to get the insider's
and
info.
If that blank person now would hear your explanation, they wouldn't understand a thing.
They should just listen and make their own, you know, perception.
Anarchy, don't you love it? That's awesome.
All right, yes. I'd say
you may try now.
Yeah, I'll try something. The idea we had was, you know, progressive metal, but with the death metal vocals mixed up with clean vocals.
Yeah, exactly.
That was our starting point. Actually, when we first started a band back in 95, I remember that we said, we're going to be a mix between Morbid Angel and Richard Marx.
that is not something I would hear in your music right now. No,
no. So it kind of changed. But it's more, I guess, we end up being called like progressive rock. We're more, it's not much metal these days, but, and we got rid of the death vocals a long time ago.
Exactly.
I think the music that we have made during the years is a kind of reflection of ourselves, where we are musically.
Question 2 is actually one that could be different for you both personally, but the question is, if you would have to name one thing which happened in your career with Wolverine, what would you consider to be the best thing that happened so far? I mean, obviously new memories can be made, but up until this point?
I think the acoustic gig we did in the US, we were playing an acoustic special gig.
That was at
Progpower USA.
Oh, okay, in Atlanta,
Like a special VIP gig or what they call it.
Awesome.
And that was a kind of, the rehearsal to that was a kind of a eye opener, I believe, to everybody in the band, because we suddenly saw that we could, you know, rearrange all the songs and make something new of the old songs.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, right.
I'd say that meeting René Jansen,
okay,
who is one of the organizers, the founders of this festival. Jansen. But, you know, René, he was the guy that signed us in the first place Cezania. He also got us on the first edition of this festival.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah. It is his. Yeah. Basically, he is the father of the festival in a way. Yeah.
So without him, you never know what would have become of us, but he kind of made this starting platform for us. And also, I'd say, meeting Oliver Phillips, because he really did help us, especially in the beginning, to evolve.
I think question three kind of speaks for itself, but I do have to ask this always, and that is, you guys are basically the most experienced band I've interviewed regarding this question, but what are your thoughts on Progpower and everything surrounding it? And be as graphic as you want to.
I can start.
He wants it.
I think that it's a very family vibe, you know, because you recognize a lot of the people that are here. You know, it's the same group that, you know, plus or minus some new ones every year. And
yeah, exactly.
But it's always a very friendly and very family.
Welcoming as well.
Yeah, welcoming.
Yeah, we just we talked about it earlier today that this is probably the best gig we get, because, you know, we've been here six times, and just as Marcus says, it's a big family. So yeah, even though we're nervous before the show, it still feels like, you know, we're safe, we're among friends.
No,
Barlow is like second home to us.
I can see why. Yes, I understand where that comes from.
Yeah, so it's really special.
Progpower was like the thing that got us out of Sweden.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd say that's
amazing.
A pretty good answer. Well, thank you guys. Thank you guys for your time. Really, really,
thank
really
you.
Appreciate it.
Thank
and thank you.
You
for a wonderful gig as well.
Thank you very much.
All right. We'll be right back.
Show can just be described as a very, very precise affair. This band knows exactly what they're doing and they're doing it well. I personally quite like it, but I can imagine Wolverine's music is not for everyone. The people who did get touched on this night, however, got touched quite deeply, and I could see a lot of people really being emotionally moved by the performance. So, guys, that is what music is all about, and you did a great job.